phone line Rahul Mehra. He's a sports lawyer and he'll help us take forward that thought that Gulu just put forth there. Mr. Mehra, can Shanti's case be taken up at a higher level? What is the procedure like, if you could help us understand?
Well, yes and no, in the sense that, you know, it is for the parent body, which is the Indian Athletic Association, as well as the NOC, which is the National Olympic Committee, IOA, which has to look into these aspects. But unfortunately, you know, all the officials out there are only interested in getting freebies at the state exchequer's expense. And the classic example of that is Mr. Bhanot wanting to go to Kazakhstan in April, Mr. Kalmati now wanting to go to London. So it's the, they are only interested in their own vested interests and least interested in athletes' welfare. So, cases like these are not aberrations. These are cases which have now come up in the open because of an active media. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, there are processes and there are processes, if it was a legendary figure, then they would have bent backwards and done everything under media pressure. The media would have been relentless in their pressure on these associations and private bodies. And therefore, some action could have been taken. But in this case, I doubt if for Shanti anybody is going to be talking or raising their voice. And officials will continue in their positions. They will go and have a gala time at the expense of the exchequer in London, come back, and this state of affairs are going to be the same as they have been in the past. So unless and until systemic changes are made, and taking the thought of Gullu's forward, mm-hmm. Where he said that the doping and other kind of things are being given, these are actually state administered ways. When I say state, I mean IOA and the federations. But simply because under their own all these things are being administered. It's there in their own camps. It's there in their own federations. Where athletes are training.
All right.
So what is it that they've done to punish mm-hmm. The officials? What action has been taken? Nothing. Only scapegoats are found, and athletes are taken to task, while their mm-hmm. officials, coaches, and the federation officials, nothing happens to them. So
absolutely, athletes are left to fend for themselves. Rahul Mehra, stay on with us. We are also taking a look here at another case that had emerged from South Africa of Caster Semenya. How the country stood behind that case and actually got the ban or the gender test that she'd failed revoked. But in this case of Shanti, we are seeing none of that happening. Rahul, can any help be rendered to Shanti? She's in a deplorable state, working in a brick kiln.
Yes, and it has to come from two institutions. One is the Athletic Federation of India, under which Shanti is recognized as an athlete. Unfortunate that she I think won a silver medal, and that was taken away because of the gender issue, and nobody came forward because these athletes are hand to mouth. Unless and until they deliver at the Commonwealth, Asian, or the Olympic level, even the government of India does not come forward to help them. So it's a catch 22, which is why right at the grassroots level, infrastructure needs to be created. There needs to be a welfare association scheme for all athletes, which has to come from the Athletic Federation and various other national federations of India.
Mm-hmm.
But these federations are so incompetent and so unprofessional because of all the wrong people heading them. Simply because of that, they are unable to muster the resources, and therefore they are unable to look after their own athletes. So it's important that not only the federations look after the athlete welfare, but also the state comes forward. Railways and other institutions have done their bit, but the corporate sector, the institutions, and primarily the federations and the IOA needs to come up with some welfare schemes, and there are none whatsoever in India.
All right, Rahul Mehra, many thanks for joining us.